Hey, what's up? This is Joseph Bells, and this is Well Connected AZ. I've been doing music in Arizona for about 15 years, but you probably only see me in the last year or 2 years. Just started kicking in the grind, you know what I'm saying? I'm really getting at it. So, the biggest fan of the Arizona hip-hop scene. You don't see as nearly as much Facebook hate as there was even last year. Last year, everyone had a problem with everything everyone was doing. But B, everyone's doing something. You can go to all corners of the state, or at least the city, and everyone's doing something. You got 126ers, you got De La Prime, Benjamin Fly, you got Justice with Monarch and RTU, Icon Radio. I mean, anywhere you look, you got Jerron Eichner. Yeah, we just went up to Flagstaff. It was dope. First time at Flagstaff doing the show. You got everybody doing everything. And I feel like if you just work real hard, and for me anyway, try to stay humble, you know what I'm saying? You end up working with a lot of dope people. So, I mean, that's what I'm doing, working out for me. When you listen to my music, you're going to get two things. A, you're gonna feel good. And I don't mean just like, oh, I feel so good. I mean like, you can feel the music, even through the radio, the speakers, the headphones. And B, if you decide to listen, then you're gonna be like, oh, I see what you're talking about. Cause I got some bars that I like sneak in there. It's almost my goal to trick you into listening to the lyrics, because it sounds good enough that the energy's there, you can feel the energy through whatever media platform you're playing it on. But then if you decide to like, break down and rewind it and hear what I just said, like, I got a little bit of knowledge I try to impart, you know, that I've learned in my 30 years of life, and I just try to sneak out into some very creative sentences. Oh my God, if I'm writing music and we in the studio and I'm writing the fourth bar and it's supposed to end with lampshade and you say it before me, you ruin my song, because now I can't say it. I can't bite if I try. Like, all I do is write my own music. I got some producers that are in-house that we all do is create. Some recorded Sun Studio, shout out D'Angelo V, the Wizard. I'm all about authenticity, like it's gotta be real from the heart. I always say this, I'd rather have 10,000 real fans that mess with me for who I am and what I actually do than a million fans that like me on Drake's level. Now, shade to Drake, but I mean, you know, works with writers, Kanye does. Everyone works with writers, not me, can't do it. Don't write my bars for me. If you write a bar and send it my way, I'm gonna say, that's a dope bar, you should rap it, cause I can't. So the Joyner Lucas Show, the most amazing show I've got to do, and a couple reasons why. A, there was 1,000 people in the crowd. I love the energy I get from the crowd because, I mean, at first, they're not there for me, they're there for Joyner. So they're not there just to say maxed out with me and my squad. So the fact that I get 1,000 people yelling my catchphrase is like the most meaningful thing ever. And B, I was hoarse, didn't even have no voice. They just literally felt it. I'm up there giving everything. Like, maxed out's just the same. Nah, maxed out how I live, bro. Like, I was out there literally giving it my all. There were so many people in there singing my brand new song, which was dope. They ain't never heard it, and they still singing along. Like, you can't get a better show than that, man. It was so dope. Maxed out. What it means is you can't turn up when you live maxed out. So you gotta go for it at all times. You gotta be everywhere, doing everything. If you listen to my music, you're gonna say, this is almost like a DMX with more bars. Or this is a little bit like a Lil Jon with lyrics. Like, I'm very hyped is what the word most of the kids are saying. I describe my style as maxed out. There ain't no other way to say it. If you've never seen the show, I got one tomorrow. Hit me up today. Tickets, if you come and say Well Connected AZ on my Facebook or my IG, I'm gonna give you tickets $10 instead of $15. So I'll show you some love just for showing me some love watching this interview. I don't do it for no clout. I do it because I love it. And you can really hear that in my music if you decide to listen to it. So josephbills.com got everything you're gonna need. You wanna get caught up? Oh, my merch. Look, got Bills. We got maxed out. We got a couple things in the works that I'm not gonna speak into existence yet because they're being worked on. But go to shopgotbills.com. Or even just josephbills.com. There's hot links everywhere. I'm about that merch life. I always got something. I got red, black, white, anything you want. Go on my website, check it out, order it. Check this out. If you order something after seeing this interview, I'm gonna give it to you 50% off. You only got until next week. I'm not gonna do this for everybody. But if you mention, I saw the Well Connected AZ, bought a ticket to my show for $5 cheaper than it should be, I'm gonna give you whatever merch you want, half price. Yes, I'm taking a loss. Is it about the money? No. We all got bills. Sometimes they blue and sometimes they past due. I just want you to wear this. Holler at your boy. Song Blah Blah is out right now. But yeah, that song is dope, super original. Real quickly about that song, because the second verse, if you catch the lyrics, you catch some knowledge. I was going back and forth this last year, back and forth with some cats about Kaepernick, or I stand with Kaepernick, aka that's hilarious, I said stand with. But yeah, so I was going back and forth with Cap. Some of my friends, quote unquote, I don't understand people sometimes. The internet really messes things up for people. But Yeah, we going back and forth. The song was done. I shot everything, recorded everything, shot the video, edited the video, all within 24 hours, just one day, everything from scratch. And then I'm done with the song. We talking on the internet like a bunch of crazy people when we friends. And I was like, you know what? Forget this. Pause the internet, go write a second verse. And I'm like, yo, what's up with the country? This song is above me. Like, there's more to this music thing than me and my brand or you and your brand. Like, people really are influenced by what we doing out here. And I just pray that day comes when I'm big enough to really change people's lives. Because there's a lot more serious things going on out there. So blah, blah is for all the talkers. Everyone just wants to talk. Nah. Sometimes sit back and listen. And if you don't want to sit back and listen, the song is for you, because you can go ahead and rap the songs to people that are hating on you in your life. Amen. My next show is tomorrow, June 23rd. Depending on when you're watching this, maybe you caught it the day after. So sorry you missed it. But June 23rd, we're doing it at Rogue Bar with Mafiotic Misfits. Them the homies, Mafiotic. You can find everything at josephbills.com. It sounds just like it's spelled. My merch is there, my videos are there, my IG, Twitter, Twatter, my snaps, my everything is right on the website, josephbills.com. It's spelled just like it sounds. Shop with me, check in, tap in with me, as the youth would say. I got some things happening, I want you to be a part of it. Thank you for even giving 2 seconds to watch this interview. Well Connected AZ, you know what it is. Yo, the night when you came in, right? You had just missed the set, like by 20 minutes or whatever. You came up to my table like, who's this? Low key, I was like, at first I was like, oh my God, Joseph, that's me, I got my shirt. And you were like, oh my God, I'm Vin. I was like, dude, like, we had been chatting a little bit or whatever, but I never met you in person yet.
Yeah.
And that was the craziest thing for me, because you showed up at my table and I'm like, yo, look at what just happened. And a minute before you walked up, someone had shared a photo like, yo, you're on the radio on 101 The Beat. They're playing my song, blah, blah, on Sunday night. Shout out Poker Face. My God. I couldn't believe it. I was like, bro, I'm on the radio. You know what I mean? And it was just funny that it was you who happened to come out, because I didn't mean to meet you anyway, and it's your station. I was like, look at this. Like, this just happened. Like, it couldn't have been planned better. You know what I mean?
So, yeah.